What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Durky Chan. Welcome back to another fragrance review. Today we have Versace Eros Eau de Toilette. But before we get into this review, guys, drop me a like, drop me a comment, say hello, say what's up, and most importantly, subscribe for more fragrance reviews and comparisons. Let's get to 1,000, guys. 1,000 subs. We killing it out here. All right, man, let's talk about Versace Eros. This one, to me, is a vanilla bomb, guys. An aromatic vanilla bomb with hints of mint and green apple. It's absolutely a amazing, amazing fall-winter fragrance. This one, to me, is going to be in my fall-winter rotation. No brainer. I've worn it a couple nights in the summer, and it works. It definitely works. In these cooler summer nights, I love that vanilla. The smoothness of the vanilla and the tonka bean is absolutely so enticing. It just has that green apple and that minty freshness to just make it not so overbearing, you know? Not like a grandma vanilla. It's a very, very refined modern vanilla smell. And that's mostly thanks to the mint and the apple. So top notes, you're gonna get that mint and green apple, very prominent. I feel like it lingers throughout the entire fragrance's life cycle. And oh my gosh, this fragrance is a beast in terms of performance, absolute beast. Mid notes, you're gonna get a hint of ambroxan, lots of tonka bean, and then in the dry down, you're gonna get loads and loads of vanilla. And the vanilla in this fragrance is an absolute star of the show, along with the performance. So in terms of performance, just wow, absolutely wow, out of my mind, incredible performance. This is the latest batch, I would say, and some people have talked about reformulations. I don't know, man, this one, to me, I've worn it the past 3 weeks, mainly in the night times. I would wear it, go out for 4 or 5 hours, go to sleep, wake up, shower, and I would still smell Versace Eros on my skin. This fragrance has one of the best performances I have ever seen. It beats YSLY EDP, beats Dylan Blue. This is by far the strongest performing fragrance I have come across. You get 10 plus hours of this fragrance lingering on your skin, and it still produces a decent 6-inch scent bubble late in those 12 hours. It's ridiculous how good this performance of this. Like, two sprays will last you the entire day, 24 hours, hands down. This one's crazy, and it projects so well too. 4 hours of projection. I sprayed it 2 hours ago, and I still get crazy whiffs of this. It's absolutely ridiculous how Versace did it. Maybe it's the vanilla base note and the tonka bean that carries it for so long, but I do have an interesting story about this fragrance. So I wore this last Saturday. I went out to eat with a couple friends. I went to the bathroom, and I came back. And then my friend went to the bathroom, and when he came back, he said, "Oh my gosh, dude, I smell your cologne in the washroom." That's how crazy Versace Eros is in terms of performance, sillage, and projection. This thing just lingers in the freaking air. Will get you a lot of compliments. If they don't get you compliments, they'll get you a lot of attention. This one is smooth as heck, extremely noticeable. If you wear more than 3 sprays, you might choke some people out, so watch out for that. This one is very, very powerful, and I see why a lot of people wear this to go to the clubs, because this thing will conquer any stinky smell in the club. Like, this thing will knock out every single smell and leave just this in your nose. This thing is absolutely a banger in terms of performance. Extremely loud, extremely attention grabbing. If that's what you want, Versace Eros is a no freaking brainer. EDT, get this if you want attention, hands down. And even if you're a lady, I feel like the vanilla in this is very unisex. It's very, very delicious, smooth. Now to me, this one again will do amazingly well in the winter. We'll cut through the code. This one to me rivals Jean Paul, JPG, Gaultier, Ultramel, and Le Male in terms of strong vanilla. But this one to me is just so much smoother, so much cleaner. And it's going to be in my winter rotation, also my club rotation. Now in terms of price, you'll get this for a decent price, 60-70 bucks for 100 ml. Perfect for all ages, I think. You could be a young guy and rock this. You could be a more refined, mature gentleman and definitely rock this. This fragrance is just sweet, warm, smooth vanilla with mintiness. Absolutely timeless fragrance, I think. Still is good in 2021. And most importantly, spraying this puts me in a great mood. I wear it around the house and it puts my girlfriend in a great mood, because vanilla, you really can't beat that scent. It's a very aphrodisiac kind of scent. So you could spray it and cuddle. I haven't done that yet. I'm gonna look forward to doing that. But Sillage, so what stands out to me about this fragrance is absolutely fantastic performance in Sillage, hands down. Very smooth vanilla. I'll absolutely love this. This one is another keeper in my rotation. Great bottle design, great vanilla fragrance, not sticky tacky, not outdated. Great vanilla fragrance for the fall and the winter. And this one is a club banger, attention grabber. All right, perfect for parties, perfect for all day winter wear, all day fall wear. Get this if you have not. I can't believe it took me this long to do a review on this. Thank you for my viewers for recommending me this. Have a good night, guys. Peace.